This is MJ with MinIO. In this last video of the lab setup series, we're going to install the MinIO client. So the MinIO client is a command line tool for interacting with MinIO object storage and other S3 compatible object storage systems. If you want to know more about the MinIO client, go check out our video series on YouTube about the MC or MinIO client, and you should be able to learn a lot more there. So you can install the MinIO client by following the documentation at this link right here. That will also be in the description. But a quick walkthrough of what you need to do. First, you will curl the download of this onto your Linux system. So you're basically downloading into this binary right here and copying it into your home directory, MinIO binaries MC. Then you're running the chmod plus x command, which basically makes it executable against that directory where you just downloaded MC. And last thing you're doing is adding MC to your path. So you're going to say append to your existing path, this home MinIO binaries directory, so that when you type MC from anywhere in your system, you're actually going to be able to reach this, and you can verify it by typing MC --help. Before we jump into the demo, let's take a look at the website. So here we are on the MinIO client website. And as you can see, it gives you a bit more context about what you're able to do with the MinIO client. But the thing that we care about here is that you can get the install instructions for installing this on whichever type of system you want to run this on. In our case, we're going to be using the Linux command. So you can see that we're using this 64-bit Intel command right here. But there's also a PowerPC and ARM installation for this as well. All right, let's jump into the demo. So here we are in our demo environment. And all we're going to do is to first download the client. So that's going to copy it into this home variable MinIO binaries MC directory. Then we're going to make the MC binary executable by running this command. This is that plus X means executable. Then we're going to modify our path to accept that MinIO binaries directory as a part of our path that we can call from anywhere. So now if I type MC --help, you can see that I get information about the MinIO client, and that is just able to be pulled up from wherever I am in my system. So that should be everything that you need to be able to follow along with the rest of the MinIO and Kubernetes installation videos. Hope you enjoyed this part of the series and hope you learned something, and we will see you in the installation part of the series. Thanks and have a good one.